a lot of fun. We will gladly introduce you to the magical world of three nations, Romania, Serbia, and Bulgaria. Students from those countries and Turkey participated in the process of creating these performances. They worked in three teams for 5 days. They learned how to work with scripts, how to represent each character with the help of puppets, and different techniques for working with dolls, and also how to make theatrical decors. First in front of you will perform the international team who will represent the Romanian fairy tale for the two sisters. Then the international team will represent the Serbian fairy tale, the prince and the dragon. And the third international team will represent the fairy tale, the adventures of the monster. And please enjoy the play.
Boxes are stored, new and old ones.
The girl was was not greedy and took the oldest box.
The old lady Nadella told her,
"Of all the boxes, you choose the oldest. Now you can go home. When you get there, then open the box."
Okay.
The girl left. On the way home, she met the bird. The girl was glad that the bird could fly. The bird got happy and gave her a beautiful bracelet as a reward for her help before.
The girl continued on her way home. She met the dog, which now was good and could take care of itself. The dog was very happy and, as a sign of gratitude, gave her a necklace.
The girl continued on her way and reached home. The father was very happy to see her. The stepmother and her daughter were jealous of the beautiful jewels. The girl opened the old box in front of everyone. Golden and silver coins glittered from inside. Everyone gasped. They could not believe their eyes and all that had happened to the girl.
The stepmother immediately sent her daughter to the same place. On the way, the girl met the dog who asked her for food. She only passed by. Then, she met the sick bird. It asked her for help. The girl just passed and continued on her way to the small house of the old lady Nadella.
"Hello, girl. What are you looking for here?"
"I'm looking. My sister was here before me, and you reward her richly. What shall I do that you reward me like this?"
I take you in my home, but you will help me with the housework."
"All right. Whatever you tell me, that's what I'll do."
"I'll tell you what to do. Early in the morning, you will clean the house, water the floors, and cook."
It's all right."
The sun rose. The girl continued to sleep. It became noon. The girl continued to lay in bed. And so the whole day.
"Dear girl, walk to the far end of the house and pick a box. When you get home, then open it."
She quickly got off bed and went to pick a box. She picked the shiniest box and went home. On her way, she met the bird and the dog, but they passed her as she passed them before. She got back home.
"Quickly open the box you carry. Where's the box, Archie? Is it neat?"
"Let's open the box quickly. Sure, there is a lot of fortune in it."
The two eagerly opened the box. From it came a strong lightning, and the box swallowed them.
The old man and his daughter lived in peace and tranquility, peacefully, happily, and richly. Thank you.
have three sons. The first son, Your Highness. The second son, Your Highness. And the third son, Your Highness. One day, the eldest of the brothers went hunting in the forest. In the forest, he saw a beautiful roe deer, which looked at him as if it was calling him. Then the king decided to call his second son to look for his brother. The second son went into the forest. Again, he met the beautiful roe deer, which looked at him with her big eyes. It seemed like it was calling him too. He also followed her, and he did not return home. Then the king called his third son.
You are the only one left to me, my son. Even if you want to, I can't let you go looking for your brother.
Father, I will go look for my brother despite the dangers.
I can't stop you, my son.
The third prince went into the forest. The beautiful roe deer appeared in front of him and looked at him with her big eyes as if it was calling him. But the prince did not follow her. He continued on his way into the forest and reached an old mill. There he met an old lady.
Good evening, old lady. What are you doing in the middle of the forest alone?
Good evening, my son. Listen, don't ask me anything more and get away from me. In this mill lives a terrible dragon who holds me captive to serve. The dragon is a monster that lures young men to the mill and eats them by taking the face.
That monster must have killed my two brothers too. So I cannot leave, but must avenge them to save all for the dragon will destroy in the future.
Then hide in the bushes. Watch and listen. I will provoke him with conversation so that you may know what his strength is.
The terrible dragon with a big head came down from the sky. Sat on the ground and immediately roared at the grandmother.
I smell human flesh. Hey, anyone come here?
Surely you smell the main expression.
You're probably right.
I wonder where your powers come from, being so powerful and invincible.
You're right. There's no one else like me on this earth. My strength lies in right here, in the balanced forest, at the end of the world, in the body of a small bird is hidden my power.
The boy understood the dragon's secret and headed to the forest located in the end of the world. There, in the branches of a tree, he found the sparrow.
Please, don't kill me. I'll tell everything you want to know.
Tell me how to take away the dragon's power. He killed my brothers, and I must take revenge and stop him from killing other people.
Your brothers are not dead. They are trapped in the dungeon of the old mill. The gate of the dungeon is around my neck.
The old lady who serves the dragon told me that he eats everyone who lure into the forest.
That's right. He only eats their souls. To free them, you must kill the dragon. His weakness is that he can see at night.
But how will I see in the dark?
Don't be afraid. Take a feather from my tail. As soon as you wake in it, in the dark, you will see everything and be able to kill the dragon. And he will not see you. Here is the key to the dungeon.
The prince has returned to his father's land. He went to the forest, to the old mill. With the golden key, he took out the feather and saw the sleeping dragon. He took out the sword and killed the dragon.
Thank you. upon a time,
there was a rooster who said, come.
It was like the other rooster.
Cuckoo-ree-goo!
His tail was green and his boots yellow.
It walked boldly around the yard, but it was very afraid.
It was afraid of everything. The dog.
Cuckoo!
The donkey.
Scared of something, it started flapping its wings and creating panic in the yard.
Once the rooster was picking grains in the yard. The wind blew and the fruit dropped from the tree. It hit the rooster.
What's happening here?
They were running, running, running.
The rooster with the yellow wool.
Cocorico!
The duck with the striped feathers.
The mouse with the long tail.
The zebra with the long ears.
Kumalisa with the shiny fur.
Ho, ho, ho.
The wolf with the scary smell.
Oh!
And the shaggy bear
with the shaggy fur.
They were running and running and running. They were running so fast that they were going to break their legs. They stopped when they saw a deep trap.
What shall we do? Do you want us to go back?
Oh, no, no, no. No going back. We didn't set out to go back.
Well, there is a deep trap in front.
We're going to jump over it. Rooster, jump first because you were first running.
Cocorico!
The rooster spread his wings and flew and jumped over.
The duck flapped his wings and swooped over the trap.
The rabbit made a long jump that not only
jumped over
the trap, but over the top of the forest.
The mouse turned. One,
two, three, four, five times!
And jump in the trap. It was Kumalisa's turn.
Huh! Is that how you jump over a trap? See how it's done. One, two, three!
Oh!
Kumalisa jumped and fell into the trap. The wolf fell after her. And the shaggy bear fell headlong into the trap where were all the other animals.
Oh, look at us! How well we did!
At some point, Kose flew over there. Kumalisa saw him and said,
Kose, Kose, please help me get out of the trap. If you help me, I will take you to a forest and show you the best tree to shrink a nest in it. While you look for food, I will keep the children safe.
How can I help you, Fox?
Throw pebbles until the trapdoor is full and we will come out of it.
The Cozy Bosses started picking pebbles and throwing into the trap. It was picking,
throwing,
picking,
throwing,
picking,
throwing,
until the trap was filled and with all pebbles and the animals came out of it.
No more pebbles falling from the sky! We can go home!
Yay!
The animals were very happy because they were safe from the deep trap and they could go home. Only Zayu Fire, come on!
Bye!
Bye! Only Zayu Fire is safe because he made such a long jump.
So now we will present you all of our characters.
The rooster with the yellow foot.
Zayu Fire.
admiration concerning your work, and I would also like to thank you for my colleague, Zorok.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.